one shot of me. Bike Across America, number 3. I'm, needless to say, but I'm very grateful to have gone twice and to have the opportunity to go a third time. All right, I'm gonna grab a rock, just a little rock, maybe this one. This is a good one. I'm gonna carry this on my bike and I'm gonna take it to Florida. We're in San Diego in a bike lane.
There's John Wiley behind me, the great John Wiley.
John's ahead of me and he's at a sign. I think I know what that says. Keep going, Steve. Hey, you notice my red socks? Those are my Arkansas Razorback socks. It does say what I think it says. Feet elevation. That means we got like another 2,000 to go.
Oh, piece of cake.
This is Julian, California. And nice little town. The big deal here is that we biked up here. Me and John, we did it. And let me tell you something.
Yesterday, I didn't know if I was gonna make it up here ever.
Again. Look at all this cactus. This is so pretty. We're biking through the Anza Borrego Desert State Park. There's lots of cactus. So pretty. And we got them on this side. Hopefully we've got more. I think we're done with the uphill. Real pretty. John's catching up to me. He's catching up.
Fact, you can probably see him in there. Go, John, go! He's faster than me, by the way.
Biking in the Southern California desert.
Not too shabby!
Look at, oh my gosh! Look at those sheep! Get out of here! Are they sheep or are they lambs? Bah! Oh, one bad back at me. Bah! I'm biking on the shoulder of Interstate 8. We are eastbound between El Centro and Yuma. Anyway, there's one in there. Hold on. Me and John. All right, this is the US-Mexico border fence. And it's kind of a tall fence. Exit 151, the bridge is just right there. We were biking and we saw the fence and we just thought we'd So there's Mexico.
I'm resting. The Imperial sand dunes are in the distance there. They're real pretty.
It's the Arizona state line with palm trees.
Not too shabby. All right, this is the town of Brenda, Arizona. Some swallows. It's kind of a deserted desert town. I don't know what that was, maybe a store at one time. Phoenix, 128 miles. There's a country store here. I'm biking illegally in the middle here. Here we are at the country store.
You're on the road.
Yeah, I'm biking to Florida.
That just amazes me when you guys do that. I get two or three a day at least.
Do you really? Yeah, right now. Yeah.
In the summertime, you'd be surprised how many.
Yeah, it's 110 degrees outside.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
So.
It's just unbelievable.
Are you open in the summer?
Yes.
Really?
Limited hours, but we are.
There's a little pass between Hope and Salome. You gotta get over this little mountain range. It's very pretty. There's some saguaros, some mountains, and there's some ocotillos. Look at that ocotillo. Let's stop and look at it. Lay my bike down. Let's go over there. Look at this. I guess you pronounce them ocotillo. Look at this. Look at this. Beautiful. There is a rooster here at my motel just hanging around. There he is. This will be a short video. I'm hopping back onto Interstate 10. I'm gonna ride the interstate because the shoulder looks much better than that crappy frontage road over there. So I'm gonna be on this for about 10 miles. You know, with the wide shoulder and a rumble strip, which is probably up there, I feel pretty safe. You just gotta kinda watch out for all this litter, all this crap on the right here. So, I'm low on data, so I gotta shorten this video, but just thought I'd do a little video. Interstate 10 East, headed towards Phoenix. I'm about 30 miles out from Buckeye. Look it up if you want. I'm biking on a sidewalk, which I'm pretty sure is illegal to bike on this sidewalk. But anyway, it's okay. There's nobody here. This is Lower Buckeye Road, headed east. Some pretty trees here. I have arrived to Tempe, Arizona. Look at all those palm trees. Sure are pretty. I'm biking on Baseline. I'm kind of way east. This is either Gilbert or Mesa. Relaxing on a couch. Not too shabby. Brian has been a great host here in the, I guess you would say the east side of the whole Phoenix area. I just passed Florence Junction. I'm on Highway 60, and there's a bunch of saguaros. Highway 60. I just passed the turnoff, which you can take the turnoff to Florence or Tucson. And lots of cactus, cholla's, saguaros, broken glass. Jeff only has one wheel. He's unicycling across America. Look at this. So I won't ask all the annoying questions that people ask you, but this is amazing. We're on a bridge. There was a sign saying, don't jump. Crisis counseling, you know, because people might jump. And surely they die. You can see the Queen Creek Tunnel up there. The Queen Creek Tunnel! Driving in Globe with my friend Mike. Not too shabby.
Wait, where's your book?
Mike bought my book and I finally signed it for him. I just put happy cycling, but When he picked me up, this book was right here in the seat. So that always scores a lot of points with me. It's the San Carlos Apache Reservation. Let me just stop for a second. That's a pretty view right there. That's the road. I started in Globe and I've been traveling this way. The lighting's better looking back. But I'm headed up. Let's keep going. Good little workout. Okay.
This video has been brought to you by the Arizona Lottery. Play here. See the gold digger guy? Come on down and play the Arizona Lottery. You could win.
Duncan, 19, Lordsburg, 55. Blaine, but...
That is why you ride a bike all over the country to meet people.
Well, that's right, yeah.
Yeah, and this is one of the people you meet.
Yeah, all right. And Bucky, I don't want to... You have any parting words?
No, not really.
Yeah?
Have a good trip.
Oh, I really appreciate
it. Hope you really make it.
I hope I make it, too. Thank you so much. There we are, the New Mexico state line. It's nice to be in the land of enchantment, right here. Oh, just kind of a basic motel room. Everything's clean. Here's my beloved bicycle. Tires are looking good. And honestly, I just like, this is my luggage. Just this top bag, then I got these two side bags, and I did bring my Chromebook for uploading videos onto my YouTube channel. That's really helpful. I've got my smartphone too, but it's good to have a laptop for a lot of reasons. And here's my Colorado jersey and my socks, and I'll just hand wash them in the sink over there. I got my first flat. I'm gonna pull my bike up here and stick out my thumb. it's not fun, but this is what biking across America is like. You have good days and you have bad days. All right, let's get going. I got to hitchhike to Deming. All right, it's like 10, 15 minutes later. Man, I stuck my thumb out. There was like 30. There's a number, a lot of semis, but you know, maybe about 30 or 40 vehicles, a few SUVs, a few that were either pickup trucks or a couple that looked like, you know, sort of like commercial trucks with flatbeds. You know, I'm sticking my thumb out in the middle out here. Every single person just drove past. There's another one right there. Pickup truck. Now, I don't have my thumb out, but look at this. I found a quarter. I found a quarter. Today's my lucky day. I found a quarter on the edge of the road. The Rancher's Grill, exit 82B, grilled steaks, ribs, chicken, cold salads. Oh, that steak does look good on that billboard. It just looks so pretty out there. Lots of yucca trees in the front and a couple of mountains. One's got a little like a weather station or something like that up there. Just kind of pretty. It's the swimming pool at my motel. Not too shabby. There's one guy, he's looking at me. He's like, what the heck? Hey, mister. Hey. Hello. What's cooking? Moving along. Oh, the things you'll see in the southern New Mexico desert. I got the wind at my back. A nice clean road. I've got nothing to complain about. And I'm at Boland's Old West Trading Post. 12 more miles to get to Las Cruces, and I bought some food and was talking to the manager, so we're having some fun. Nice place. All right, I'm riding with my buddy, Jay Hughes. Jay Hughes of Las Cruces.
Hello.
There's my bicycle. There's the Texas state line. All right, today's my day off. I'm in downtown El Paso. There's a lot of commerce that goes on with Juarez and El Paso. The border is just up there a little bit. I might stop by there. Boston Electronics. Hey, you're in the wrong city. It's El Paso. It's pretty steep right here. And I just crossed into Hudspeth County. Look at that cactus. He's in the left lane. Puffing and popping. Puffing and popping. Woo! Oxygen. I need more oxygen. It's Salt Flat, Texas. Gotta keep the wheels going. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Nice views that way. Pretty nice. Oh, that tailwind is nice. Keep pushing me, keep pushing me. Here's the sign for Guadalupe Mountains National Park. The elevation is 5,695 feet. Not too shabby! YMCA, do-do-do-do-do-do, YMCA. When you need a good meal, or you need a hot shower, just go to the, oh, hey there. I'm just biking here in southeast New Mexico. Sometimes I sing to pass the time. There it is, the Welcome to Eunice sign. And over here it says, City of Eunice, friendly people, proud town. Hi. And I bet you that trucker is proud to be from Eunice. Lots of friendly people here in Eunice. It's Thursday, day 22, at the Texas state line. Andrews County. Look at this amazing scenery. Wow. All these smelly refineries of some kind, or whatever they are, related to oil. Corporal Ray's coffee shop. Thank you very much. I got a caramel pecan decaf latte here. You know, I bike through a lot of desert, and but this is the most ordinary and scenery-less place I've ever biked through. There is just nothing. I'm almost done with today's ride, and there is someone on the side of the road. Is it a friend, or is it a foe? I shall find out very soon. Oh! It's a friend! It's Glenda! Hey, Glenda! I got the video going, sorry. All right, it's day 24. And this video begins with me sitting in a car on a highway with Sean and Glenda. We're headed to a bicycle shop in Midland so I can get a new tire and figure out the pump issue, and I need to buy new gloves, and my bike is in the back there. So I took the front wheel off. I took the bags off, you know, the panniers and the trunk box. That bike is so light when everything's off of it. We're having a lot of fun here in West Texas. I got Interstate 20 on the left and a train on the right. This is where I'm sleeping tonight, on that inflated mattress. And where am I? I'm inside the First Presbyterian Church. I'm here under an overpass, exit 249, I'm a little bit west of Sweetwater, and I'm not feeling that well.
I am actually laying down here in Brian's passenger seat.
We're here at the Budget Inn, and I just got a room. I'm not feeling well. I just feel a little hot. And Brian, any words of wisdom for me?
Get some rest. That's all I can say. You got to get your body back where it's going to go.
I don't want to be too dramatic here, but I'm lying on my bed here. I haven't even bothered to take my shoes off or my socks. Something's clearly wrong, and it's probably just heat exhaustion or just a little stomach bug. Back on the road again. It's a nice cool day. And I'm headed in this direction. Just one problem. Headwinds! The wind's mostly coming out of the northeast and just slamming into me. So, but you know, all things considered, I'll take it. It's a new day, and I'm just gonna take my time and keep riding east. This is insane. Bill Rogan is riding with me. I see a bicyclist coming at me on this frontage road, middle of nowhere. And, you know, I was gonna wave to him, I think I did. Yeah, all right, it's Bill Rogan from Denver. He drove from Denver to Abilene, Texas to kind of surprise me and ride with me. So, oh my gosh, Bill.
I couldn't let you do this trip all alone.
And how long of a drive was it from Denver?
About 11 hours.
11 hours.
And it's such wonderful scenery. If you like flat dirt.
It's the morning of day 28. This is my hotel room. I stayed here last night and I've got a rest day today. So this is the man responsible for my free hotel rooms. So appreciate it.
Sure.
So.
This is not the most scenic part of Abilene right here.
No, it's not. I know. This is downtown Abilene. Not too shabby.
Steve Garufi joining us for the second time in the history of our show.
His annual appearance.
Yeah, it's so good to see you, man. How are you?
It's so good to be here. I made it to beautiful Abilene, Texas. It took me 27 days to ride my bicycle from San Diego to here.
Remind our audience why it is that you've chosen to ride your bicycle across the country a couple of times now.
Honestly, I hate to say it, but it's just sheer craziness. I mean, it's still wonderful to bike across America. I know it's this incredible dream to achieve, but I mean, I'm suffering from the day-to-day, and that's, I'm always tired.
Sure.
I'm on these really lonely, windy roads. You know, when I cross into Texas, all of a sudden the wind has been an adversary.
Oh, yeah.
You know, when I pretty much across New Mexico, I had 3 or 4 days where the wind was just howling at my back.
Oh, that's always nice.
And it's like I got angels pushing me.
What is it like when you come to the Rocky Mountains? When you have a mountain range in front of you and you see it off in the horizon, you know you got to go over it. What's going on in your head then?
Yeah, there's certainly that moment of fear and, oh my gosh, that looks hard. And you just have to be one pedal stroke at a time. And you just stare at your front wheel and you say, as long as that front wheel keeps moving, eventually this will pass.
Yeah. Of course, on the way down, it's pretty fun, right?
Oh my gosh.
Take your foot off the coast.
Yeah. You know, you're going like maybe 4 miles an hour climbing up. And then if it's a strong enough hill, you're going like 30 down.
But you got to be careful, don't you? I mean, on your way down, that's pretty dangerous.
It is more dangerous when you're going that fast. So, yeah. Yes.
Wow. And there's no way to get all the way across the country without coming across some mountains, is there?
But the good news is you're pretty much totally done with mountains.
Yeah,
I'm going east.
Yeah.
Right? There's no real mountains in the southern states.
Where's the final destination? You said Florida. Whereabouts?
I have friends in Titusville, Florida, and we're going to finish at the Cape Canaveral National Seashore somewhere. So, and I have two friends that are going to kind of be biking with me.
Oh, that's cool.
And we're going to have a ceremonial ride where we'll go about 10 miles along the beach on a bicycle trail.
Oh, that's
then
cool.
Whenever I feel like it, we'll all just crash into the ocean.
I like it. Just ride your bike right into the ocean.
That's right.
This is a great life, man. This is a life I think I'm getting into later. Yeah.
I want to be you when I grow up.
All right. It's day 29. I'm headed out of Abilene, and I got three riders with me. I've got Coleman, I've got Sarah here, and Kirsten. Hopefully the camera gets Kirsten. Wave, Kirsten. And I got Colby driving that truck. I'm riding with another guy. Another friend is riding with me. This is Wid. Your name is spelled W-I-D, right? Your name's so cool.
Thank you.
You're a hay farmer. Yep. That is so freaking cool.
Thank you.
You grow grass, and you sell grass.
Yes.
We got this one little hill. We've just arrived in Comanche. Good little hill. I'm calling it a touch of Colorado. In Central Texas. Good little workout. Woohoo! You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar.
Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire.
Try to set the night on fire. All right, I'm going up a hill. East of Gatesville, Texas. And who's behind me?
It's Jeff. Say hi, Jeff.
Of course, with Jeff as my support vehicle, I've got nothing on the back. All my bags are in Jeff's trunk. See how light it is? Nothing. Nothing right there. So, just much lighter bike.
This, my friends, is Waco. And it's a good thing I'm off my bike. I did cross the city limit.
Jeff, once again, thank
you. Hi, Internet.
Thank you for driving 100 miles to be my support vehicle.
You're welcome.
I'm going to buy you dinner.
Whoa, oh my gosh, look at all that water.
All right, just off the edge of the road are these blue bonnets. This is my motel room, and there are cinder blocks holding up the bed. Look at that, there are cinder blocks. It's warming up a bit. I got my third layer off, I've got my bright fluorescent jacket on. There I am, and moving right along. Day 34, the bike ride for empathy. Really pretty morning. All right, I'm at the old Cherokee Trading Post in Maydell, Texas. And here's inside the Maydell Trading Post. So this is the friendly owner. She's really nice to me. Right up here is something special. Halfway across this bridge, I will be out of Texas. That's pretty. Actually, you know, Texas was good to me. Texas was a good state to me. And Louisiana! I'm here! Louisiana, baby! Logansport, Louisiana. Nice big truck here. There's some buildings. Gateway to Louisiana. Logansport. I'm in Louisiana! Woo! Papa, don't preach. I'm in trouble deep. Papa, don't preach. I'm in trouble deep, 'cause I made up my mind. I'm keeping my baby. Doo doo doo. I'm gonna keep my baby. Ooh, oh, sorry. I was singing there. Just passing the time here in rural northern Louisiana. All right, I'm here in a convenience store in Campy, Louisiana. I got my Starbucks drink here, and some Mentos that I'm almost finished with, and the woman, the cashier, was really stunned that I had biked across America, and there's a guy I was talking to in that pickup truck right there. Real friendly guy. Take care. He waved back at me. He was real nice. I should have got a picture with him. It's a Louisiana sunset! Not too shabby. Louisiana Highway 34, turn left. A great place to visit, shop, and live. Winfield, birthplace of three governors. Tulos, Natchez, that way. So you can get the hell out of Louisiana. Like that. It is just so humid and kind of murky. There's just lots of pools of water and swamp land. It's just good to be in Louisiana. You know, when you're in Louisiana, it's just a state of mind. Louisiana is a state of mind. You know, I'm talking northern Louisiana. There it is, the Mississippi River. Here's the bridge. I'm in Natchez, Mississippi. And I should like do a little dance or something. Do little shadow dance. Do 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 do. I am resting. I took the day off. I really needed to rest physically for my whole body, mentally, spiritually, and just everything. It's day 40 of my Bike Across America ride. Not too shabby! Staying left of this rumble strip. There's not many cars and everyone's moving over. Day 41. I'm still on Highway 84 East in southern Mississippi. Same view as yesterday. There is this deli called Burnham's Deli. And it is 85 degrees and I just told this woman, I ordered a roast beef sandwich. I just told her, I was like, I'm so happy your business is here. This is a thick roast beef sandwich. Look how thick that roast beef slab is, so.
I wanna talk about how things are going and how I'm doing. The last 10 days, there's just been a grind to this whole bike journey. It's kind of boring in Mississippi and Louisiana and East Texas. It seems like all I'm doing is biking on these boring roads in the South, and I just try to get to a convenience store so I can get inside and it's not as hot and I can, you know, buy another cold drink.
I'm calling it a day. It's too hot. I've gone like 35, 36 miles. It was pretty stressful biking from Collins to Hattiesburg. I got nothing against Mississippi, and I met a lot of friendly people, but I'm just kind of...
Can I say it? I'm just getting fed up, getting a little tired. It's day 40. I've been on the road for 42 days. I'm just getting a little edgy.
I'm on the campus of the University of Southern Mississippi. There's a nice little waterfall here.
I'm from Colorado.
Are you really?
Yeah, I'm not from around here.
I'm from Philly.
You're from Philadelphia? Mississippi or Philadelphia, Pennsylvania?
There is a Philadelphia, Mississippi?
Yeah.
I've been in Boston for a long, long time.
How'd you get down here?
Snow. Kept running away from it.
On the road again. Da 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 da. On the road again. Da da da. Da 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 da. I am on the road again. I did something kind of fun at one of the shops. I pulled out a $20 bill and I just asked the woman, she's kind of young. I just said, hey, do you need money? And you know, she was kind of confused. And I just gave her a $20 bill and I walked out. Not too exciting, I guess, but Alabama! It's a train! I'm biking across America. Yeah, I started in California and I'm finishing in Florida. Oh, you too. God bless you. All right. Look at all this water. This is actually Mobile Bay. And that's I-10 above me. My friend Michelle picked me up.
Not too shabby.
There you go.
Hi. You gotta turn it off now.
No, so, please, sorry.
Please turn it off.
No, okay, don't.
I can't hold a smile for very long.
All right, well. Michelle!
There's my smile while I'm trying to drive.
Michelle's my friend in the Florida Panhandle, Western Florida.
Yes.
So she's picking me up. And there's my bike, by the way. And by the way, this totally works out because I'm crashing at her place and then tomorrow it's gonna rain. So there's no point. You know, I'm not gonna ride tomorrow, so it'll be a day off. And then, you know, she's gonna generously drive me back to Locksley, and I'll start on Sunday.
It's only 2 hours. It's not a longer trip.
It's a 2-hour drive, so
not bad.
That's very generous.
2 hours isn't bad.
Driving with my friend Michelle. Not too shabby! I feel like I'm emotionally cheating by I'm gonna be crossing into Florida 2 days before I actually, before I cross into it with my bicycle. She might take me to the beach tomorrow.
That's a double cheating.
But anyway, when I cross, I'm officially in Locksley with the bicycle. So when I cross into Florida, I'll make a big deal.
But I am going to walk into the Gulf of Mexico here. And enjoy the, I don't know, do you call this an ocean? Isn't this the Gulf of Mexico? It's not an ocean. Either way, it's pretty.
Welcome to Florida sign. Open for business.
Let me say right now, cycling in Florida is amazing.
there has been a bike lane, like, with a sign that would, I just went under. A designated bicycle lane. It's like night and day compared to Alabama or Mississippi. So thank you, Florida! It's the Florida High Point! Not too shabby! The bike ride for empathy. Here I am motoring along, or I should say pedaling along. All right, I am walking. I'm not riding my bike. And this is the Georgia state line right here. I'm in Georgia right now. Woohoo, Georgia, Georgia. What am I doing in Georgia? And Lois, my new friend Lois, she's been following me on Facebook. She tracked me down. She lives in Tallahassee and she tracked me down. So, hey, you're a Florida State fan?
Oh yeah, I graduated from Florida State.
This is the Seminoles country.
Oh yeah, both my kids graduated from Florida State. My dad graduated from Florida State.
So you don't like the Gators? Is that?
Who's that?
Oh.
We don't talk about that.
Okay. When you think of the number 50, what comes to mind? $50? A $50 bill? Super Bowl 50? That's when the Broncos defeated Carolina. That was a good Super Bowl. 50 pairs of socks? 50 birds chirping in the forest? Well, I'll tell you what I think of.
I've been on the road for 50 days.
All right, I'm in Live Oak, Florida, and I'm in the left turn lane. My finger is out. I've been on Highway 90, but I'm turning right onto Florida Route 100. 90's to the left. So long, Highway 90. It's been a great road to me. My bike. I was thinking about buying two shots of whiskey. Drinking one. This is at when I get to the beach. Drinking one, then pouring the other on top of the bike. It's been a long journey. For sure. Right, it's the afternoon. I've gone about 73 miles. I'm on Highway 1. This right here might be the best setup. I've got a shoulder. And I got these tall trees providing shade. I'm on Highway 1 in Port Orange. I just want to say that I've ridden a century. My cyclometer reads 101 miles, and I'm so proud of myself.
Here comes Steve Groofy, not so shabby. About to finish Florida up.
Atlantic Intercoastal Waterway. I'm almost done with this trip.
Almost done. Almost done.
I can see the ocean out there on the horizon, just a few miles out. Unbelievable. Tomorrow, Jeb and I will have a ceremonial ride. I'll be, I don't know, a half mile from the beach tonight. So, pretty amazing. New Smyrna Beach, Florida. This town has been like an abstraction for the last 7 weeks. It's just crazy to actually be here. Right here, this black Jeep has Jeb and Tina. Hey, say hi. They're my friends. And they served as the seventh support vehicle. My heavy bags, all of my heavy bags that I've been carrying on the bike is in their Jeep.
Incredible, I'm still stunned that I'm here in New Smyrna Beach. Totally stunned. And this distance right here is all that remains before my trip is over.
Biking with my friend Jeb.
Not too shabby.
I'm at the Cape Canaveral National Seashore with Jeb, who's riding with me. This will be my last Facebook Live video right here. The ocean is just like ahead of that ridge. I mean, it's like not even, I guess, a tenth of a mile. So this is our ceremonial ride.
It feels bittersweet. It feels, I mean, I feel sad in some respects, but I mean, I'm also just overjoyed. There's a lot of feelings, you know.
I was just telling Jeb, for so many days in especially Texas, East Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, I just had the attitude of, oh, just get this done. I'm over it. Let's get more mileage, keep going. Get more mileage every day, get done. And, you know, yesterday I got into New Smyrna Beach and there was this feeling of just being stunned, like I've arrived. There is no tomorrow, you know, other than this little ceremonial Sunday morning ride with Jeb.
Here comes Steve, gonna finish up his ride. There he goes, Dan. Here he goes.
You know what? I think I want to quit. It's too hard. It's just too far away to bike across America. I'm going back home. I quit.
I'm gonna quit. There's just too much. I think I'm just gonna pack it in. Just go back to Colorado. I'm sorry, I quit. I'm going back.
All right, here we are, the Atlantic Ocean. I only have that much to go. Go down that ramp. Jeb will probably be taking pictures of me. I might give him my camera as I crash into the ocean and whatever. All right, Steve.
All right, we're ready.
You ready to hit it?
It's time. It's time.
Welcome to Florida, bud.
I took my helmet off, too. All right, here we go.
Well, let's finish it up, brother. There goes Steve. He's going to finish the ride up. Go, Steve, go. Finish the ride up, brother. Steve, what do you have to say for yourself?
I'm tired. It was worth it. And that ocean is so nice just to sit in there. Woohoo! That's all I gotta say.
This is Steve and Steve's wallet that rode for 53 days with him. It's a little tattered. He's a little tattered, but congrats, Steve. Welcome to Florida, brother.
Thank you. That is a really nice beach. Like, I'm going to go and just sit in there for a while. Oh, my God.
Woo-hoo. This is what you do when you go 53 days across America. There's Steve enjoying the Atlantic Ocean. Hey, Steve, say hello.
Hi. This rock, it doesn't weigh too much, but it's not light either. I've carried this all the way from San Diego on my bike. And now I'm at a beach.
Florida, the Atlantic Ocean. Should I just throw it in there really far?
Yeah, why not?
All right, here it is. I'm gonna throw it right now. So long, Rock. Enjoy the Atlantic Ocean. I wanna say thank you to everyone, especially my YouTube viewers, my subscribers, friends, just everyone.
All the people on Facebook, just everyone who encouraged me in emails, texts, phone calls.
I want to say thank you. And I don't know, I'm not really feeling that emotional or I don't know what. I just want to go swimming right now.
So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go swimming. Thanks again. All my love to you.
The bike ride for empathy. It's been fun. It's been hard. It's been long. And like I said in the other video, it's been worth it. Go out and follow your dreams. Take them on. It's worth it. It's the Atlantic Ocean. And having just biked across America.
Not too shabby.